Bumblebee bat is very tiny, only an inch long, but that's still pretty big as far as life goes. To find out the Earth's smallest living things, we're gonna have to look a little bit harder. Hey guys, Julie here for DNews. How small can life get? Well, bats and humans come from the domain Eukarya. The smallest member of our domain? Prasinophyte algae, a single cell of which can be 800 nanometers across. But that's still kind of large for life. Microorganisms from the domains archaea and bacteria exist on an unimaginably tiny scale. How small is small? Well, pretty dang small, according to new research from the Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory and the University of California, Berkeley. The researchers captured the first detailed microscopy images of ultra-small bacteria that are so tiny, 150,000 of them could fit within the width of a human hair. The researchers think these ultra-small bacteria are the smallest life can get at an average volume of 9 cubic nanometers. So yeah, they're tiny. So where do they come from? Well, probably everywhere. This sample, however, was scooped from the groundwater in Colorado, but researchers think they're quite common. Using high-tech imaging, they found that they're pretty simple organisms. The cells have densely packed spirals that are probably DNA, and not very much of it. Their genomes are only 1 million base pairs in length. In comparison, we have about 3 billion base pairs in our genome. Their small genome leaves them without many vital functions, so maybe their hair-like appendages are kind of like a life support system that connects them to other microbes to trade nutrients. This new discovery could unseat the previous candidate for the smallest living thing. Mycoplasma gallisepticum, a parasitic bacterium that lives in the guts of primates, can be around 200 nanometers across, which fit with what researchers thought was the minimum size required for a free living cell to, well, live. Scientists haven't really agreed on how small life can get, but researchers from a workshop hosted by the National Academy of Sciences theorized that a cell must be at least 200 nanometers across, otherwise it couldn't fit stuff like DNA and proteins that are kind of needed to live and reproduce. Looking at another domain, archaea are simple single-celled microbes that can get pretty tiny too. Research from some of the same team from the Lawrence Berkeley Lab in UC Berkeley found archaea also with a cell volume of 9 cubic nanometers. And in case you were wondering about viruses, viruses are really freaking small. Some can be only 20 nanometers across, but they aren't considered living since they need hosts to reproduce. They exist in a kind of half-alive gray area, so they don't really count. Switching gears to a more human scale, we are really happy that our new channel Seeker launched this week. Here on DNews, we take a look at the news from a science angle, and they take a look at the news from a human side. Like this video here about a teenager that built a braille printer out of Legos.
He made his printer for a local science fair in his hometown of Santa Clara, California, but when people caught wind of it, they started asking if he could make a version that they could buy. So he launched a new company called Brago Labs, a combination of braille and Lego.
So make sure you check that video out. It's the first link in the description, and subscribe to Seeker so you never miss a video.